Lesson 3, customer service, the key to customer loyalty. Good customer service is the lifeblood of any business. Despite efforts to carry out big promotional campaigns or offer reduced prices to bring in new customers, with poor customer service, they will not come back and your business will not be profitable for long. In this lesson, we'll go over some critical components of excellent customer service, which is at the heart of your relationship management on a day-to-day basis. Let's look at customer service and customer loyalty. Creating loyal customers means focusing on good customer service. This is especially critical to small businesses because good customer service can be the difference between competing and surviving or failing. You may have all the elements of customer service in place, that is, from customer service representatives to return policies. But if your customers are not satisfied with the way their transaction was handled or its results, they will not come back. The challenge you have there as a small business manager is to consistently meet customers' expectations and continually improve customer service. Creating a long-term repeat group of customers leads to a loyal customer base. There are a number of benefits of offering the best customer service. Let's look at them. The first one is you'll generate positive word of communication. Customers judge the customer service of every business they deal with, and they're much more likely to share bad ratings with other people than good ratings, so you need to make sure your customers are happy. Another benefit of offering the best customer service is you'll be able to compete with larger retailers. This is because you as a small business can actually be in touch with your customers and make a personal connection with them, which the larger firms may not be in a position to do. Now, how can you constantly and consistently exceed customers' expectations? Cafe Paradise, for instance, could do this by developing standards of performance on critical areas of service delivery, like how long a client sits down before a waiter appears, the greeting of the customer, the getting of the order right the first time, standards on meal preparation, standards on cleanliness of the premises, or any number of key criteria to meet and exceed customer expectations and provide excellent customer service. Let's now turn our attention to the principles of a good customer service program. Remember, you'll be judged by what you do, not what you say, and so it is vital to ensure that your business consistently does certain things. Listen to your customers. Always make an effort to listen and put in practice what you hear. This demonstrates respect and care for your customer. Another principle is to make sure that you keep your promises. Reliability is key to good customer relationship, and good customer service is no exception. For instance, if the manager of Cafe Paradise promises one of their customers of the outside catering that they'll deliver the meal by noon, they must make sure that the delivery is made by then. Therefore, think before you give any promise, because nothing annoys customers more than a broken promise. The third principle is to deal with customer complaints promptly. This will position your business to reap the benefits of good customer service. In conclusion, therefore, we've seen that customer service is key to building loyal customers. We've discussed the benefits of practicing good customer service and highlighted the elements of a customer service program. In the next lesson, we'll go beyond the common elements of any good customer service program and look at the key strategies all companies should put in place. Please ensure you've understood by completing the assessment and activity.